This weekend is Saturday the 8th and Sunday the 9th of February, beginning the fifth week of Ordinary Time. The choir of Westminster Cathedral sing Crucifixus by Antonio Lotti. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He died and was buried. In this weekend's reading, St. Paul tells the Corinthians what it was like for him when he first spoke to them of the good news of Jesus. This Paul brought faith to more people than anyone else and helps to shape what we now call Christianity. But here he tells a very real story of what it means to be Christian. Paul admits that all he brought them was news of this crucified Christ, and that he brought it in weakness and fear. He doesn't try to draw people by strength, confidence, or even certainty, but instead shows who he really is to them, and so who Christ really is. To be Christian is to choose a God who became human, a God who chose to be vulnerable, a God who draws us to each other through our vulnerability. We are called to find ourselves, to be whole, to be as vulnerable as we are, and in this vulnerability, this humanity, to find God. So take time now to listen to this part of Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, and notice how open he is to those who would call him saint, his vulnerability, and what it means for him to build this church of God.
When I came to you, brothers and sisters, I did not come proclaiming the mystery of God to you in lofty words or wisdom. For I decided to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. And I came to you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. My speech and my proclamation were not with plausible words of wisdom, but with a demonstration of the Spirit and of power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God.
We are surrounded by a pressure to be strong and independent, as if to be weak is to be broken. How do you experience this pressure? Do you feel comfortable with it? Or is it a strain? St. Paul recognizes that in speaking to the Corinthians, he was weak and fearful. Yet he continues this great task of demonstrating power in faith. Think of those times and ways in which you have felt weak and fearful. Perhaps times when you have been under pressure to perform. How did this feel? How did you deal with this? Did the pressure overcome you? Or did you overcome it? To be Christian is to choose a God who chose to be vulnerable. Sit for a moment with this. God is almighty, but he chooses to be with us in our weakness. How does it feel to choose a vulnerable God? Ours is a relationship of vulnerability. As people who choose this God of vulnerability, we, like St. Paul, are drawn to follow him in becoming fully human, becoming open, vulnerable, and real. Pope John XXIII said that tenderness is strength at its fullest. As you hear the reading again, try to think about what it means to be drawn to be more human, more vulnerable.
When I came to you, brothers and sisters, I did not come proclaiming the mystery of God to you in lofty words or wisdom. For I decided to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. And I came to you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. My speech and my proclamation were not with plausible words of wisdom, but with a demonstration of the Spirit and of power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God.
Before we finish, spend some time with the Jesus who is gentle and lowly. Picture him with you where you are now, in that time and place when you are most vulnerable, or perhaps alongside a homeless person or someone else who is vulnerable today. Talk to him about those things that are most vulnerable in you today, or just be with him in your shared weakness. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son,
and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Amen.